Hi guys, this is Evan.
I will always be thinking, what could I have done more to have prevented this from happening?
Suicide and mental illness is not talked about openly.
I'm Doreen, I'm the mother of Evan Low.
I'm Elaine, mother of Zen.
Evan was 11 years old when he passed away through suicide.
My son, Zen, took his own life about 1 month before his 18th birthday.
I think what contributed to Evan's death was actually a combination of many factors. Other than his autism, who made it very difficult for me to socialize. I think he was also going through tremendous stress in school because as a society, Singapore is very competitive. And especially for boys, they feel that coming out to say, I'm depressed, I feel sad, is exposing their vulnerability. It is just, in an Asian culture, it just doesn't seem right for a boy to be weak. They're expected to be strong. They're expected to uphold the family. So that, it's a lot of stress for a boy to take.
For Zen, or in my family, I think there's definitely a genetic predisposition. But only with Zen's passing, I have my cousins who actually shared with me of their own struggles. You know, many families are in denial because of the shame. It's embarrassing for them to admit that my child has a mental illness. Families think that if we acknowledge it, it becomes contagious. It's a taboo, it is a stigma, so they don't recognize it and they don't offer the right help for their children who are struggling. I've known of some fellow suicide bereaved mothers that their own family do not even know that their child has taken his own life or her own life. Instead, they would actually say, she's gone away to school. They might get ostracized, or the family member would be upset with them and says, why are you shaming us? Please Stay movement is really the first ground advocacy group by mothers who have lived experience of losing their child to suicide, calling for a national strategy on suicide prevention and mental well-being.
We don't want youth to think that telling people that they're depressed makes them weak. We want them to know that it's okay not to be okay. I know that it's very challenging to grow up. There are many, many new emotions you're going to go through. But I would like to say, take your time to grow up. You don't need to meet the expectations of anyone. And your life is very, very precious to a lot of people who love you. I hope that many years from now, you will look back and you'll tell yourself that I'm glad I stayed for the people I love and for myself.